everyone, and welcome back. I'm going to be jumping on something a little different today. This is my son's little go-kart, little Beetle go-kart. And this came off of the frame itself was off of a Disney car ride. I'll put a picture right here and you can see what it looked like when we purchased it. And so there is a complete another different body that we can put on to this frame. So that's kind of a neat thing. And we put a little Harbor Freight engine in it, and then it's running, it's actually two-wheel drive, running two pulleys to a chain drive on the wheel. And Dad got it to this point to where it's drivable, runs, drives, and stops kind of. You can see a band brake there, and I need to put something to keep that over and actually finish the job. But Dad got it to this point. It does have an actual Beetle steering box on it. Tie rod ends, a whole nine yards. Pretty cool little design here. And so the hard part is done, and we are left with kind of the purdies, kind of making it look cool. So we're going to put some headlights in it. I'm going to put a fog light on it, a horn on it, all that kind of stuff, and put some interior in it, put some sheet metal up here in the back, and the floor needs to be kind of modified a little bit, and we'll bead roll some of that. I'll put the taillights on it, that kind of thing. Roll bar, all that kind of stuff. So this is the little fog light I found in my stash for it. I found a horn in the hoard. I'm going to put that on there. And then we've got an accelerator laying up here. I probably am going to do something like a rollerball accelerator on it, kind of like what was in the early Beetles. So we're going to be jumping on this. I don't know how much of the boring stuff I'll film for you, but I'll turn you back on when I get a chance. Well, I've taken the body off, and it's a little chilly outside today and kind of rainy, so we are experiencing a little bit of small shop problems. But it's okay. I can work in an environment like this for a short period of time, so it's all good. I have taken apart Dad's welds. No offense, Dad, but I need to teach you the technique of tack welding when you're mocking something up. I really appreciate what Dad did, though, putting this all together and getting kind of the workings of it figured out. Now I just got to make it pretty. The steering column was shifted over quite a bit, so we made it straight. And then I've taken the deck that the body was sitting on here, taken that off, and I angled the pieces back. So this angle piece here, rather than having it just be, Dad had just squared it off and over. So he had one of these right here. And the problem with that was when the body was on the car, you looked at it from the side and you could kind of see all of that, and I didn't like that. So we are now working on the brake, which is back there. And this is what Dad had welded up that sits inside that little brake right here. So he had welded this to there, and I'm gonna drop that piece down and just weld it to the bottom side of this axle tower here. I think that'll work just fine. And then the brake going up to the front of the car is this piece here, and I wanted to run it under the floor. He had it on top of the floor. I wanted to run it under the floor, so I put two 90s in it, so it'll go in there, drop under the floor up to the pedal. So that is what I am working on now. So I gotta patch up what I cut apart up here, kind of fix that all back up all nice and pretty, put the brake on, and then figure out a gas or accelerator cable. And when I welded the pieces, I left, when I put the angle pieces on, I just cut the center piece that Dad had used prior. But it wasn't quite long enough, so I had to sleeve over in a couple of places. Not my typical, I don't like working like that, but I didn't want to go buy new metal because I'm cheap. So that's what we've got. So let me get that brake kind of hooked up and get that all kind of where I think it needs to be, and get the pedal welded onto something up here. I have to make whatever I come up with come apart, because if we ever have to take the floor off, the floor just bolts with these U-bolts here. So this frame that's underneath is original to that Disney car. The ride it was on was called Autopia. You can look it up. I think it started in the 60s. But we want to be able to use the other body as well. So that's why we put this deck on here for the Beetle, because that raises it up and allows it to clear the wheels. The wheel wells on the other car body are just a little bit bigger. So let me get on to that brake back there. The pedal hooked up, and get the steering all tightened back up. And then I need the notch on the Beetle frame itself. Right here, I need to kind of notch a little arch where the steering is so that the car body won't keep banging there, because it's just fiberglass and I don't want to bang a hole in it. Fiberglass, when you have repeated stress kind of banging on that, it'll eventually crack it and break it. So we want to make a notch so that doesn't happen. Clear as mud. I'll bring you back. That's a couple days later, and I have just slowly been kind of working on this little cart. I've built the little pedal latches, if you will, the little hookups for the pedal, and I've made them where I can adjust it just a little bit if I need to. And I really would like to put them on the decking. So there's, if you can see that or not, but the floor is actually going to sit up here. So I really would like to put the pedal up on that floor, but that worked as a really good stop when the pedal pulls back. So we're going to try it there. I had him sit in it yesterday, and it seemed to be about the right height for him based on the seat that I'm planning to put in there. I added a brace support to the middle of the floor right here, and then I have added a little battery tray and just welded a couple of washers to some angle, and then strapped the battery in back there. I would like to run a generator on it, but for right now we're just going to run just a battery from his, he had a little Gator, John Deere Gator, battery powered Gator, and it's whatever this brand, Peg Perego. And so I've yanked the wiring harness out of that, so we have that to work with, so that we can then just hook that up to his headlights and his horn and all of that. And then the throttle cable, I have come up with a Volkswagen, some kind of Volkswagen accelerator. I don't know what that's out of. Gia, maybe? I don't know. So that's going to be our throttle, or at least that's what I'm planning on using as the throttle. So it's starting to come together now. I got new U-bolts for the floor, and I have a seat from a 59 Beetle that's in pretty rough shape that we're going to cut up and make that his seat. So it's coming along. It's just one of those time-consuming things, a little bit here, a little bit there. The brake I have ready to go. I welded a little washer, just cut a slit in it, welded it under there just to kind of keep it from vibrating when it comes from, there's just a band brake on the back here. So I'm going to keep at it, and it's just slow going, not filming a lot along the way. And when I get to a point where I can show you something we've done, I'll bring you back. I thought I'd mention, while I have the body off, this mechanism here adjusts, so it will pivot either way. These are 50-inch belts that are on here. So to tighten the belt and the chain, we can move that a little bit. It comes real close to the body, but it misses, so that's why that system is like it is. And this is, again, original to the way the Disney car was. And that's just been modified slightly so that we can adjust. Those didn't move before. They do now. Well, we're making a little bit of progress. I've got the floor part, first part, bead rolled and in. I just made kind of a hump in the middle, and the next one will just lap over or lap under, whichever way. And then this back panel here, there'll be a piece that comes up and over. And then the back of the car has this opening here. I'm just going to make a piece right here that attaches and closes that off. We'll leave the wheel wells and everything open so that everything can vent out. But I want to close off all potential for fingers and hands and whatnot into those pulleys, hair, ponytails, you know, that kind of thing. So it's not a perfect bead roll job, but it's not too bad. And one more side to do over there, and then make this piece, and then that kind of horseshoe-ish piece back there, and I'd say we got that pretty well whipped out. So throttle's hooked up, and the brake hooked up. I don't have the pedal brackets final welded. I really don't have anything final welded. Kind of wait till we got it all mocked up. I made that little tab there for the throttle. So I think we're hooked up. This is still just a little bit long, but I'm going to leave it that way till we're sure that's where that needs to go. So I can always just tie it back too. It works better if you can just make a more direct shot, but for now, I think I'm going to call it a night. Pretty happy with how that turned out. Looks pretty good. And then I'll get the seat. I had him sit in it, and it comes. I need to make the seat come to about where the middle divider is there. And I'm probably going to make it slightly adjustable. And the seat back, I'm going to make it actually hinged like a Volkswagen, so it'll fold down like a regular car. Fold down, not necessarily just a Volkswagen. But it will cover to about right here, about in the middle of the gas tank. And then to fill it with gas, it'll just push the seat forward and fill it with gas. I think that'll work out okay. So I'm going to call it a night, and you'll pick up where I start tomorrow. It's coming along. Finally getting it. Finally knocking it out. So it's going to be fun. Fun little ride. Let's take a look in the garage. I have this tiny little space. It's a good thing it's not any bigger. Believe it or not, my Mini and my Land Rover will fit in here. All right, I'll see you when I pick back up the next time. Wanted to show you real quick. Tonight is the pink supermoon. That is pretty awesome. Doesn't do much on film, but when it first came up, it was gorgeous. I think tomorrow we're supposed to be able to see it too. I love this time of year. Well, it's another day, and it's a gorgeous day. Carry the body out here, and I want to put a chrome strip on that just to see what it looks like. And then the hubcaps came in, the baby moon hubcaps. It came with three of them, and they're in decent shape. Right over here. But since we only had three, and my son has added his flare, and if you notice, it's his best attempt at a VW logo in the middle of the hubcap. But that's what I had, and I went ahead and just, they were cheap enough, I just bought him some new ones. So these are the pieces that are going back on the car at some point. You'll be seeing those pieces again, but we'll open that box of hubcaps and put those on and see what that looks like. So let me get you set up here, and we'll drill some holes in the fiberglass body and put that chrome strip on. This is the narrower chrome strip, so I don't have any of those little tabs that go in it, so I'm going to use a screw. Stick that in there. Seems to slide pretty well, and then we'll just put a nut on the backside. So I think five will be enough. Need to cut that strip down too. Basically just need to make sure I've got 20 between where that starts. I'm using a seamstress tape because I could figure I could make the curve a little easier. 20. Yeah, we should be able to get it with that. All right, we'll get those holes drilled and I'll bring you back. Nothing like drilling into a perfectly good fiberglass body. Alright, that's all in there nice and purdy like. I like that. Should we add it to the side too? I know, that looks pretty good. Let me go get another piece of trim and I'll tape it up on the side and we'll see how it looks. These trim pieces kind of get a buildup on them. I don't know if that's coming through in the camera or not, but over time they just kind of build up this. It's almost like an oxidation on there. And so I'm just taking a little bit of ultra fine, get you in focus there, ultra fine steel wool, and you can see how it's starting to take it off of there. So we're just gonna go over that. I think the side piece is going to look cool. We'll shine it up and then we'll tape it on. I don't know, what do you think? I think back here is okay. Up here is okay height-wise. Right here in the where the door is a little low. So we're going to bring it up a little bit maybe. Kind of contour it to the body. I like to leave it one piece if I can. You know, on a regular beetle, or I guess I should say on a real beetle, you got this body line that goes kind of all the way down to the front fender, all the way to the back fender. But it'd be nice if we could just keep that the same chrome strip, not cut it down. I like it. See if we can make it work. Still looking at the trim piece on the side. I think I like it, but go ahead and open up these hubcaps while we're waiting on that. Waiting on me to decide what I'm gonna do. Probably gonna end up putting it on there. Hopefully these are the right size. Oh, they sent a sticker. That was nice. Let's see what we get here. Now, I'm gonna go cut that with a pair of scissors. That way if we have to send them back, we can heat seal that back together. So I got that one cut open and I'm looking at the sticker and it says 8 1/4 inch outer diameter. That is not what I ordered. These should be 8.5. The inner diameter should be 7 5/8. So let me go get a tape measure and we'll see what those are. So what's our chance of them fitting the first try? Huh? We're gonna go from divot to divot. And we're at 7 1/4 inch. So I have a sneaky suspicion these are gonna be too small. Shall we? Now I have bought these in the past and cut slits in them. We had a camper once that had kind of an odd size and I cut slits and then just pushed out the tabs to make them fit. That's a problem. Bummer. Well, those are gonna have to go back. I'll call them and see if they make... If they actually make a... Well, hello there. If they actually make a 7.5. Well, that stinks. They're pretty too. Won't be putting those on tonight. Oh well, we'll move on to something else. So we'll either give Speedway Motors a call or we will call Amazon or ship them back to Amazon. Bummer, dude. We got that second floor, the 4-part bead rolled. Still need to do the back part here. When I go to put it in the car, we are hitting on this engine mount right here. So I'm going to take the plasma cutter, lay a piece of angle there, and cut that so it's a little bit straighter. I don't need a whole lot more room. This needs to go that far. Not hitting me by much, but it's in my way. So we're going to cut that so we can put our other piece of flooring in, and then we can cut up some seats. So I had to step on my new bead rolled floor, but it does want to hit right here. So we're going to take a piece of cardboard and the contour of the interior of the Beetle, and we will cut that piece down. So I have this pile of seats. The blue ones came out of the 59 parts Beetle, and I'm not sure where this one came from. And then I've got this one out of a later Beetle. And I think probably our best bet is probably this guy for the bottom, for the seat bottom. I was going to use those two because they have the sliders on them, but I think we're just going to make a stationary seat that doesn't move. So we need to cut that frame up and make it fit in the car, and then I need to make a seat back. What did you name the car?
Musty.
Why'd you name it Musty?
I don't know.
Because you have Dusty is your bus?
Yes. So it can rhyme.
Oh, it's a rhyming one. But it's not Musty 1, just to be clear. Right, is it Musty 2?
No, just Musty.
Okay. Musty.
How about you plasma cut the 6 on here?
Well, I don't think so.
6. They are metal, all right.
So Dalton has named the car Musty. I promise I was no influence on that. You just came up with that all by yourself, didn't you?
That's the only name I can think of.
Okay.
Because Dusty was already taken.
Dusty was already taken, and Rusty was already taken because that's the name of Mama's double cab. Right?
And Ruby was already taken.
And Ruby was already taken. So we got our chrome strip on. Dalton has decided he does want chrome on the side, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But do you want it cut where the door slits are? Like Daddy said?
Yeah.
Okay. Go look at Daddy's and then come over here and tell me. Alright, we're going to get back to work on this seat. Well, it certainly doesn't look like much right now. I took the bottom section, took a chunk out of the middle. Took this chunk out of the middle right here. So we took that out. And then I left the two edges, the two corners. And this should have been this way. Essentially. And I took that out because we want to make the seat the less deep. So we're just going to flip those the other way. Remember we had that. I'm knocking off all my tools here. There we go. That's going to go something like that. So that's the bottom part, and then I cut 2 inches out of this piece, so that'll get welded something like that and come in. This kind of gives it that contour for the back to fit in, the way that little curve's cut in there. And so those will come like that, and then these springs I probably will go through and cut to about right here, or maybe start here, and then that'll get tucked in up under kind of where they were before. So that should be his little seat. Well, we're in the process of getting it done, but we've got a big storm coming in, so we're gonna quit for tonight. It still needs some work. The whole thing's kind of mashed a little bit. That seat was kind of rough when I started with it, so let's see if it fits in the car. Hey, Dalton, let's see if it fits in there, bud. Get out for a minute. I know, you have to get out.
Wait.
And I don't want you sitting on this seat because it's hot. Moment of truth, I guess. We got to get it down in there past the sledge. Don't push it. Well, we're definitely done for the night because we just lost power. So I have my shop light kind of shining down. But that is going to work perfect. Really can't see much, but it's going to work. After I get it all buttoned up, it's going to be good. So, with that, everyone, I want to call it an evening and call this video quits. And we'll see you the next time, hopefully, when we have power.
Yeah.